In the previous lecture, we have studied about the introduction part of the evolution, that is how evolution takes place and some of the theories about the origin of the life or the about the origin of the evolution. So, today and also about the some evidences, evolutionary evidences or the experimental evidences of the evolution which was performed by Miller and Urey. Both of these scientists have maintained the structure or the both of these scientists have maintained the environmental conditions which was similar in the previous environment, and they maintained such type of conditions in their laboratory, in their apparatus which they had made. So, today we are going to study about the evidences of the evolution. Evidences of evolution. There are certain evidences, like हम कैसे पता कर सकते हैं, क्या सबूत है कि evolution इस type से हुआ है, तो उसके evidences आज हम पढ़ेंगे. तो there are certain things like we can the evidences about the organs or about the anatomy of the organisms, about the morphology about the organisms, or there are some distribution on the earth. कि earth जब पहले एक single surface था, उसके बाद में कैसे उसमें distribution हुआ और कैसे geographical barriers बने to distribute one part of the earth from the another part of the earth, और कि previously जो ancestors present है और अभी जो new today's man are present, तो what are the similarities and what are the dissimilarities between both of them, between the ancestors and between the today's man. So, by studying all these aspects or all these categories in the evidences of evolution, we will discuss about these things. So, what are the evidences of evolution? We will study these evidences under certain categories. The first is morphological and anatomical evidence. Morphological and anatomical evidences. In this category, we will study about some morphological and some anatomical changes in the organisms. कि पहले वो कैसे थे, अब कैसे हो गए हैं, या बहुत सारे organisms मिलके किस तरह से behave करते हैं, what are the changes in them, कौन से organs पहले present थे, कौन से organs अब present है, these type of organs or these type of study we will do in the morphological and the anatomical evidences. The second category in this is paleontological evidence. Paleontological evidence. In this category, we will study about the fossils. कि कौन सा fossil या fossils हमें कहाँ से मिले, fossils क्या होते हैं और कैसे हम fossils से evolution के बारे में पता कर सकते हैं कि कौन सा fossil कब present था. तो ये वाला fossil अगर यहाँ पर present है, तो ये कब present था, and about the age of that fossil. कि ये कितने साल पुराना है, this type of things we will study in the paleontological evidences. Third category is embryological evidences. In this embryological evidences, we will study about the similarities between the ancestors and between the today's man. Ancestors में जब during the development of the today's man, though why they follow, or we can say that during the development of the today's man, are they क्या वो follow करते हैं ancestral trait जो है, क्या पुराने टाइम पर जो एंसेस्टर्स में ऑर्गन्स प्रेजेंट थे, क्या ड्यूरिंग देयर एम्ब्रियोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट दैट ट्रेट हैज बीन फॉलोड ड्यूरिंग देयर डेवलपमेंट और नॉट. दिस टाइप ऑफ स्टडी वी विल डू इन द एम्ब्रियोलॉजिकल एविडेंसेस. द नेक्स्ट कैटेगरी इज मॉर्फोलॉजिकल, पैलियंटोलॉजिकल, एम्ब्रियोलॉजिकल एंड बायोजियोग्राफिकल एविडेंसेस. इन दिस बायोजियोग्राफिकल एविडेंसेस वी विल स्टडी अबाउट दैट अर्थ पहले एक यूनाइटेड स्ट्रक्चर था, एक बहुत बड़ा स्ट्रक्चर था. उसके बाद में कैसे उसमें डिफरेंस आए, कैसे अर्थ के पार्ट्स अलग अलग हुए, कैसे कॉन्टिनेंट्स बने एंड जो ऑर्गेनिजम्स पहले यूनाइटेड अर्थ में प्रेजेंट थे, जब अलग होने के बाद में जब वो अर्थ कॉन्टिनेंट्स में टूटा, व्हेन अर्थ वाज डिवाइडेड इनटू कॉन्टिनेंट्स एंड ऑल द ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर आल्सो सेपरेटेड विद दैट कॉन्टिनेंट्स. तो जब वो सेपरेट हुए तो हर एक कॉन्टिनेंट का अपना एक अलग इन्वायरमेंटल चेंज बना, अपना एक अलग इन्वायरमेंट बना. तो उनमें क्या क्या चेंजेस आए, दैट विल बी स्टडीड अंडर द बायोजियोग्राफिकल एविडेंसेस. द फिफ्थ एंड अवर लास्ट कैटेगरी इन द एविडेंसेस ऑफ इवोल्यूशन इज फिजियोलॉजिकल, साइटोलॉजिकल एंड बायोकेमिकल एविडेंसेस. इन दिस वी विल स्टडी अबाउट वेरियस मेटाबोलिक प्रोसेसेस, वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ फिजियोलॉजीज एंड साइटोलॉजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज, और वी कंपेयर द वेरियस मेटाबोलिकल प्रोसेसेस इन द ऑर्गेनिजम्स. So, these are the categories of the evidences of evolution which we are going to study. First, we will discuss about the morphological and anatomical evidences. The morphological and anatomical evidences, these are also called as tectological evidences. The study of the anatomy or the structural anatomy of the organism is called as tectology. So, the morphological and anatomical evidences, anatomical property is also called as tectological evidences. In this, we will study about the certain organs, like first category in this is homologous organs. So, what are homologous organs? The organs which have same origin, the organs which are having the same origin, same basic structural plan. Organisms which have the same origin and same basic structural plan maybe they have different functions. Same origin, same basic structural plan, but they are having different functions. Origin same hai, basic structural plan same hai, par function alag alag hai. Let us take a couple of examples to understand these homologous organs. The first, hands of man and forelimbs of horse. Hands of man and forelimbs of horse. They are having the same origin. The tissues which are involved in the origin of the hand of the man and the origin of the forelimb of the horse are the same. Therefore, they are having the same origin. And if we talk about the same basic structural plan, that is, we are talking about the skeletal or the skeleton muscles which are found in the hand of man and the forelimb of the horse, they are also same. We are having one humerus, radius, ulna and phalanges. In the forelimb of the horse, they are also having humerus, radius, ulna and phalanges. Therefore, the hand of man and the forelimb of the horse, they are having the same origin, same basic structural plan, but the function is different. The hand of man, we use our hand in walking purposes, but forelimb of the horse is used in movement or locomotion. So here hand of man and forelimb of the horse are homologous organs. Next, hand of man and flippers of whale. Hand of man and flippers of whale, again they are having the same origin. Tissues which are involved in the origin of the hand of man and the origin of the flippers of the whale, both are same, but their functions is different. Again, the hand of man is used in walking purposes, but the flippers of the whale are used in swimming. Next, hand of man and wings in birds. Hand of man and wings in bird, they are also homologous organ. Same origin, same basic structural plan, but functions are different. Hand of man for working purposes and wings of the birds for flying purposes. So, now we will discuss about some more examples. The organs in vertebrates. If we talk about heart, heart in vertebrates. When we are talking about the vertebrates, we are talking from fishes to mammals. From fishes to mammals, we are talking about the heart. The heart of a fish is two-chambered, having only one auricle and one ventricle. When we talk about the heart of an amphibian, it is having three-chambered heart, two auricles and one ventricle. In the reptiles, they are also having, some of them are having 3.5-chambered heart, but some of them are having 4-chambered heart, like crocodiles and alligators. And in birds and mammals, they both are having the 4-chambered heart. So, in heart, the tissues which are involved in the origin of the heart or for the development of the heart is same in all the animals, in all the vertebrates, from fishes to the amphibians, and their structural plan is also similar, that all are having the ventricles and the auricles. So the organs in the vertebrates are also homologous organs. The next example we are talking about is mouth parts of इंसेक्ट्स, माउथ पार्ट्स ऑफ इंसेक्ट्स. सो कॉकरोच, हनी बी, मॉस्किटोस एंड हाउस फ्लाई. माउथ ऑफ अ कॉकरोच, हनी बी, मॉस्किटोस एंड हाउस फ्लाई, दे आर ऑल सिमिलर इन द ओरिजिन. द टिश्यूज विच आर इन्वॉल्व इन द ओरिजिन ऑफ माउथ ऑफ द कॉकरोच आर द सेम टिश्यूज विच आर इन्वॉल्व इन द ओरिजिन ऑफ द ऑल दिस थ्री ऑर्गेनिजम्स माउथ, बट देयर फंक्शन इज डिफरेंट. कॉकरोच इज हैविंग बाइटिंग एंड चीविंग टाइप ऑफ माउथ. कॉकरोच का माउथ बाइटिंग एंड चीविंग टाइप का रहता है, काटता है या फिर कोई, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ईट समथिंग देन इट विल, कॉकरोच विल बाइट इट एंड देन आफ्टर इट च्यू इट. सो इट इज हैविंग बाइटिंग एंड च्यूइंग टाइप ऑफ माउथ. हनी बी, इट इज हैविंग च्यूइंग एंड लैपिंग टाइप ऑफ माउथ. हनी बी का माउथ स्ट्रक्चर च्यूइंग एंड लैपिंग टाइप ऑफ माउथ. मॉस्किटोस, सकिंग एंड पियर्सिंग टाइप. मॉस्किटोस का सकिंग एंड पियर्सिंग टाइप, दे फर्स्ट पियर्स अवर स्किन एंड देन सक द ब्लड फ्रॉम अवर बॉडी. सो दे आर हैविंग सकिंग एंड पियर्सिंग टाइप ऑफ माउथ पार्ट्स. एंड हाउस फ्लाई, दे आर हैविंग स्पॉन्जिंग टाइप. स्पॉन्जिंग टाइप इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज हेड रोटेटिंग टाइप. स्पॉन्जिंग टाइप, हेड रोटेटिंग टाइप. एज वी हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड, हमने ये देखा होगा कि सपोज इट इज अ हाउस फ्लाई, सो अगर यहां पर कुछ भी खाना है तो इट विल स्टार्ट रोटेटिंग इट्स हेड इनटू इट. वो बार 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 अपना सर उसमें घुमाती है. देयरफॉर इट इज हाउस फ्लाई इज हैविंग स्पॉन्जिंग टाइप ऑफ माउथ. दो देयर ओरिजिन आर द सेम, ऑल द इंसेक्ट्स आर हैविंग द सेम टाइप ऑफ ओरिजिन, but their functions are totally different from each other. Therefore, the mouth parts of the insects come under the category of the homologous organs. Let us take some couple of examples from plants also. The tendrils of cucurbita and thorns of bougainvillea. The tendrils of cucurbita or the tendrils of passiflora. Passiflora is also called as passion flower. The tendrils of the cucurbita or the passiflora and the thorns of the bougainvillea, they are homologous organs. How they are homologous organs? Because their origin is same. Both of them have been originated from the same position. Suppose this is the stem and this branch. This is the axial position. It is the position where thorns are also developed and it is the position from where the tendrils are also developed. Axial position se hi thorns bhi develop hote hain and axial position se tendrils bhi develop hote hain. So both of them are having the same type of origin, but the function in the bougainvillea, the thorns help the plant or the thorns protect the plant. from the herbivorous animals. But in the case of the cucurbita, these tendrils, or in the case of the passiflower, these tendrils help in the climbing, because both cucurbita and the passion flower both are having the soft stem. They are climbing, climbers or creepers. So they are not having any kind of support. While they are not having the support, these tendrils help them to climb over the surface. So these are also the homologous organs. One more example, phylloclade. In Opuntia, what is phylloclade? We have seen the Opuntia, this the flat leaf like structure. This is the phylloclade. It is the flat leaf like structure which used to float over the surface, over the water surface. So ye jo flat leaf like structure hai, it is actually the stem. So the phylloclade in the Opuntia and other plant stems. Phylloclade in the Opuntia and other plant stems, they are homologous organs, because the phylloclade, it is the green or the flat leaf like structure, but it is actually the stem, and the other plant stem, they both are having the same origin. The tissues which are involved in the origin of stem in the other plants are the same tissue which are involved in the origin of the phylloclade also. But here in the Opuntia, the phylloclade are involved in the photosynthetic processes. Yahan par phylloclade se photosynthesis hota hai. But other plant stems, they are not at all involved in the photosynthesis. They are just used, or they are just used to support the plant, to support the tree and the branches. So the phylloclade in the Opuntia and the other plant systems, stems, they are also homologous organs. Now, this is about the homologous organ. One more thing, while studying about the homologous organ, it resembles with one property of the evolution, that is divergent evolution. So, what is divergent evolution? If one organism is having one special type of organ, one organism, one special organ, and this organ transforms into the different other, transforms to perform different other functions. तो अगर एक ऑर्गेनिज्म के पास में एक स्पेशलाइज्ड ऑर्गन है, तो उनका ओरिजिन तो सेम है, बट ट्रांसफॉर्म होके वो अगर दूसरे दूसरे फंक्शंस परफॉर्म कर रहा है, देन इट विल बी इन द कैटेगरी ऑफ द डाइवर्जेंट इवोल्यूशन. द ओरिजिन इज द सेम, बट इट डाइवर्जेस और इट आउटबर्स्ट. ये अलग अलग कैटेगरीज में जो डिविजन होता है, जो आउटबर्स्ट फ्रॉम द वन थिंग द वेराइटी ऑफ द थिंग्स आर बींग डेवलप्ड, और फ्रॉम द वन थिंग द वेराइटी ऑफ द फंक्शंस विच आर परफॉर्म्ड, दिस कम्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ डाइवर्जेंट इवोल्यूशन. सो होमोलोगस ऑर्गन्स, while talking about the homologous organs, the divergent evolution is also the example or the category under the homologous organs. So this was the first category about the morphological and the anatomical evidences. The next we will study about the analogous organs. Analogous organs is the second category in the morphological and the anatomical evidences. So Here in the homologous organs, we have studied that they are having the same origin, same basic structural plan, but the functions are different. But and these homologous organs are just opposite, are quite opposite to that of the, sorry, the analogous organs are quite opposite to that of the homologous organs. So, what are analogous organs? The organs which are having the same function, but their origin is different. Analogous organs are having the same functions, but their origins is different. Let us understand it by taking some examples. The wings. Of birds and wings of insects. Wings of birds and wings of insects, they are analogous organs. How they perform the same function, unka function same hai. Both of them, birds and insects, use their wings in flying. वो दोनों उड़ने का काम करते हैं. Wings are used in the for the purposes of flying. But their origin, birds के जो wings होते हैं या the origin or the wings of the birds are having some skeletal structures in it. They are having bones and muscles in it. But the wings of insects, they are just the chitinous, they are made up of the chitin, or they are having just chitinous thing. Okay. The wings of the birds and the wings of the insects. Wings of the birds have the skeletal structure, but wings of the insects are just made up of the chitin. Unka origin alag hai, but they are performing the same functions. Next. The eyes in cephalopoda and the eyes of mammals. Eyes of cephalopodic animals and eyes of mammals, they both are having the different type of origin, but they both are performing the same functions. We are also using our eyes for the visionary purposes, for the perception of the light, and cephalopoda, they are also using their eyes for the visionary purposes. Therefore, the eyes in the cephalopoda and the eyes of the mammals, they both are analogous organs. Next example, the sting of honeybees and the sting of scorpion. Sting of honeybees and sting of scorpion. Sting means dung, to jise wo kaatte hai. To the sting of the honeybees and the sting of the scorpion, they both are having the same function. काटने के काम आते हैं, डंक है तो उससे वो काटेगा ही, but they are having the different origin. The sting of the honeybee is an ovipositor, or the egg laying apparatus. It is the ovipositor or the egg laying apparatus. तो ये इससे एग ले करती है. बट द स्टिंग ऑफ द स्कॉर्पियन, इट इज द लास्ट एब्डोमिनल सेगमेंट. ओविपोजिटर है ये, ये आगे की तरफ प्रेजेंट रहता है एंड इट इज द लास्ट एब्डोमिनल सेगमेंट, ये पीछे की तरफ प्रेजेंट होता है इन द टेल्सनरी पार्ट, पीछे वाले पार्ट में. सो दे बोथ आर हैविंग द डिफरेंट ओरिजिन बट दे बोथ आर हैविंग द सेम फंक्शंस. नाउ वन मोर एग्जाम्पल, द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द फाइलोक्लेड विच वी हैव ऑल्सो स्टडीड इन द होमोलोगस ऑर्गन्स. द फाइलोक्लेड in Opuntia and the leaves of other plants. The phylloclade in the Opuntia and the leaves of the other plants, they are also analogous organs. How they are analogous organs? Because earlier I told that phylloclade is a stem which is having the leaf like or the flat leaf like structure and it performs photosynthesis. So the phylloclade in the Opuntia, which is the stem part, and the leaves in the other plants, which are the leaves, they both are having the different origin but they both are performing the same function, that is photosynthesis. Therefore, the phylloclade in the Opuntia and the leaves of the other plants also comes under the category of the analogous organs. One more example, potato and sweet potato. So, potato and sweet potato. In this, the potato is the modification of the root and the sweet potato is the modification of the stem. They both are having the different functions, but they are having the same origin. They are having the different origin. One is the modification of the stem and another one is the modification of the root. Though they are having this different type of origin, they are performing the same function. Unka function same hai, origin alag hai. One is root and another one is stem. So, this is about the analogous organs, which is the second category of the morphological and the anatomical evidences.